So I'm gonna go do pig chores. Hi, piggies. Four Lakes Farm is my business. I raise sheep, pigs, and cows. It's particularly important this year to build wallows for the pigs because we've been in somewhat of a drought. So right now they're 6 months old, so they're getting close. I'm getting close to being bacon.
This is Leanna Mulverhill. She raises livestock for meat shares on Four Legs Farm in Hudson Valley, New York. But she's actually relatively new to farming. Up until 2 years ago, Leanna was on the path to becoming an engineer. But after college, she realized that she didn't want a desk job. Instead, she wanted to become a farmer. However, that decision didn't come lightly.
I do not come from a farming background. It took me a while to have the courage to be a farmer.
It took courage because there are a number of hurdles preventing young people like Leanna from taking the leap to become a farmer. Today, only 6% of farmers in the US are under the age of 35, which for the agricultural industry is a problem.
We are in a farming crisis now, where our farming population is aging out and retiring, and we need young people to take on this role of growing our nation's food. But they're facing incredible challenges in doing that, including access to land, capital credit, student loan debt. Many young farmers today are discovering agriculture in college. They're not growing up in farm families, and this debt that they've accumulated from college is preventing them from getting started.
Leanna was fortunate enough to qualify for a unique loan forgiveness program in New York, which allowed her to pay off her debt and kickstart her business.
Without the loan forgiveness program, financing the farm would have been more challenging. I'm very thankful to be a part of it, and it definitely cushioned my first couple of years farming.
But the loan forgiveness program hasn't solved all of her problems. She still has to work another job to make ends meet.
Most of the time I work 12-hour days, and I can't really leave the farm for more than a few hours. I don't really take days off. I always have to do chores, and then I go to my job at the National Young Farmers Coalition, which is also a key piece of figuring out how to make this work financially.
Young farmers have to be extremely creative to make it in agriculture today. Whether that's working several jobs or finding land through a land trust or a current landowner who's willing to let them use part of their land.
The National Young Farmers Coalition hopes to help young farmers in that cause.
In the next 25 years, two-thirds of farmer-owned land in the US will transition ownership. If young farmers aren't successful in taking over this land, it's possible we'll start importing our food from overseas. This is a national security issue. We need farmers in the United States growing food for our country.
Essentially, this means that the US could become more and more dependent on other countries for food. What the NYFC are fighting for is to give young people like Leanna the financial support to continue and sustain the farming tradition in the US. Until legislation to support young farmers is realized, folks have to do the best with what they have. For Leanna, this means applying for grants and renting rather than owning land for her animals.
So I move the sheep every 3 days to a new spot. And as you can see, they've eaten a lot of the grass over there.
One day, Leanna hopes to eventually own her own land and expand her meat share business.
I love getting to provide my community with really healthy proteins. It feels really special that it's people I know that are eating the meat. Hopefully it makes them healthier and improves their quality of life. My life, my world revolves around being at the farm and taking care of my animals. I do get to work in a beautiful place. I do get to see spectacular sunsets, and I get to see baby animals playing, and it's definitely a privilege to be able to be here at all. I try really hard not to take it for granted and to take pause and make sure I'm drinking it all in.
To hear more about the farming crisis and what NYFC are doing, check this next episode out on Seeker Daily.
Some states have even started offering student loan forgiveness to new farmers, adding to the current list of forgivable occupations, such as teaching and law enforcement.
We believe farmers can produce good for their community, steward the land, and feed their communities, and at the same time, be profitable businesses.
Thanks for watching, and be sure to subscribe to Seeker Stories for new videos every week. Thank you.